Hi yogis, welcome to Open Air Flow at Yoga Factory. We hope that this will help you stay in your practice and just get on the mat and move. While our studio is closed, we were forced to close, so we hope to open ASAP and we will keep you posted with that. But in the meantime, here's a nice hour flow for you to just get moving. Hopefully you can turn off your AC and get a nice little sweat going, or better yet, maybe do it in your backyard. If you hear any background noise, you guys know what open air is like. Sometimes there's traffic, sometimes there's movers. Who knows what'll happen out there. But anyway, I love the breeze and I'm happy to be offering this to you. So let's start in child's pose. And in your child's pose, just bring your big toes together, knees are apart. Start to extend the arms out. Get present with the sound of your ujjayi breath. And keep lengthening through your arms, through your spine. You can always stay still here or pick your torso up and walk it over to the right. Maybe right hand on top of the left. Back to center and over to the left. Same thing here. Stacking your hands, getting that side body stretch. Something that reminds us this is only temporary. And spread through the fingertips and lift up to the tabletop. Curl the toes under, drop the chest, and inhale, look up. Exhale, round, tuck the chin in, press the tops of your feet down. Inhale, curl the toes under, drop your chest, and look up. And exhale, round. Tops of the feet down. Good. One more. Inhale, curl the toes under, look up. And exhale, round. And then draw your knees together, feet together, curl the toes under, and sit back for a toe stretch. So I always like to just kind of peel the toes and make sure even those little pinky toes are getting the action here. If you feel pressure in your knees, you can always grab a block. And by the way, guys, if you don't have blocks at home, no big deal. Grab some big books, grab some Tupperwares. You might smash your Tupperware if you sit on it, but I don't know. You might have a really durable Tupperware. Books, pillows, blankets, you know, you improv, make it work. So you can put that block underneath just so that there's less compression in the knee if that bothers you at all. And then I always like to place the hands behind, do something with the arms to hopefully distract us from the fact that we feel like our toes are breaking off. So you can stay here or wrap your arms around and kind of push your knuckles forward as you squeeze the elbows together. And then option to twist to the left. And then back to center, release your arms and wrap them around and over to the left. Kind of pull your knuckles forward, squeeze the elbows in. Option to stay here or twist to the right. Keep breathing. You might notice your knees kind of sliding forward. That's actually a good sign because you're getting deeper into your toes as you do that. Back to center. Release the mind. By the way, someday, maybe the tops of your feet would touch the tops of your toes. Could happen. Release that. Tap out your toes. And then keep the tops of your feet down and sit back. So you can stay here, or you could lift one knee at a time if you need more. You can lift both knees, or maybe you place a block under for a little more relaxation. Today, I feel like I need a little more core, so I actually want to hold my legs up. And you kind of pull your belly in and up so you feel your go the other way. So tops of your hands are down, palms are up. Feel free to make fists, bend and straighten your arms. Good, release that and shake out. And then walk your hands to the top of the mat. Spread the fingertips, drop down to the elbows, and straighten out your legs. Shift a little forward and back so you feel the movement happening from your Achilles. And pause. Push back through the heels, pull forward to the crown of the head. Lift your kneecaps up and pull the pubis bone forward. So right now I feel my whole front body engaged. If you stay here long enough, you might start to shake. Keep breathing. Good, and then let all that go, lower down to your hips and your legs for Sphinx Pose. Walk your legs back, feeling a decompression out of the hip joints, and pull your shoulders back and down. Look over to the right. Maybe you play with moving your chin up or down. I like that sometimes, getting more of a neck stretch. And then you can go over to the left, shoulders back again. Kind of move your chin up and down. Back to center. And just relax your head. Let your head hang. Feel that decompression of your cervical spine. Relax your lips away from your teeth. Slowly lower your forehead down. Walk the hands back under your shoulders. Squeeze the elbows in and inhale for Cobra. Keep the back of the neck long. Work on strengthening your lower back muscles. And lower down. And spread through the fingertips, curl your toes. Press back through the heels so you feel your kneecaps lift. And then push straight up to plank. Exhale back, down dog. Good. Might be the first down dog of the day, so feel free to kind of walk it out. Bend one knee at a time, shake your hips side to side, relax your neck. Just kind of let it feel good. And of course, nobody's watching you. And I'm not your alignment drill sergeant today. So give yourself permission to, you know, just kind of explore. Maybe do things a little differently. Even though you've got a guide with me, you know, you might shift a little. And give yourself this time to explore in your practice. Good. We'll come into a plank pose, pause. And exhale, chaturanga. Inhale to upward facing. Pull your shoulders back, open up the chest. Maybe rock a little side to side. And then roll back to downward facing dog. Come high up onto the toes, spread through your toes, and then push the heels back and down. Step the feet together, lift your right leg about a foot off the floor, and then lift the left heel. Lower right heel, ball toes, and then lift your left leg. Right heel, heel, ball, toes. Right leg, left heel, heel, ball, toe. You're starting to feel the connection to your core, hopefully. As you try to keep your palms down as long as you're able, and then slowly parallel your feet, soften the knees, inhale, lengthen, and exhale, fold. Feel free to grab up a seat elbow. Release the elbows, come up to the fingertips, inhale, lengthen, and exhale your left foot back. Left hand stays down, right arm lifts for a twist. Squeeze the right knee to the midline, rotate your top palm, and reach over the right ear. Look under the right arm, keep straightening through your back leg. Inhale, arm lifts up, lower the hand, and step straight back to a down dog. Look between the thumbs, bend the elbows, and inhale, scoop into upward facing dog. Exhale back to downward facing dog. Inhale, right leg lifts, hips stay level, reach back through the heel. Sink your left heel at the same time. Good, knee to nose, shift it forward, and lunge the right foot. Stay low through the legs, inhale, arms lift up for crescent lunge. Keep straightening your back leg, start to reach forward, lower the hands, left foot forward, top of the mat. Inhale, halfway lift, exhale the right foot back. Inhale, the left arm lifts. Lower the hand and step back to down dog. Look between the thumbs, bend the elbows, inhale, scoop to upward facing. Exhale, back to downward facing. Inhale, left leg lifts, hips stay level. Get longer for your left leg, but sink your right heel down. Exhale, lean your nose, and lunge the left foot. Arms lift, down and up. Stay lower for the legs. Keep straightening your back heel, or your back leg rather. Reach forward, lengthen, and lower the hands. Right foot forward, tap on the mat. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, fold. Step the feet together. Big toes touch, bend the knees. Arms lift up for chair pose. Exhale, fold forward, Uttanasana. Inhale, lengthen, look up. Exhale, walk or jump back. Chaturanga. Inhale to upward facing. Exhale back to downward facing. Left heel turns down, right foot lunges forward, arms lift. Warrior one. Oh man. I don't know why I thought it was a good idea to put my hair in a ponytail. I never practice with a ponytail. Anyway, pull your right foot back, get a little deeper through your hips. Start to reach forward, lengthen. Hands down, step back. Inhale, upward facing. Exhale, back to downward facing. Other side, right heel turns down, left foot lunges forward, arms lift up, warrior one. Pull the left hip back, get deeper. Exhale, lower the hands, step back, chaturanga. Inhale up, and exhale back. Spread your toes, heels are slightly turned apart. Come high out of the toes, walk or jump, feet to hands. Inhale, lengthen, exhale, fold. Big toes touch, bend the knees, arms lift, chair pose. Sit a little lower. Ardha Utkatasana, half chair. Get the length through your spine, keep shifting the weight into your heels, and you can lift your ten toes. Then reach your arms back. Start to lift your hands higher. Squeeze your arms together. Feel your triceps working. Lace the fingers behind you, or you can use a towel or a strap or something that you have at home. And start to fold. Keep pulling the hands over your head as you slowly start to straighten your legs more. Keep pulling the hands away from your spine and breathe deep. Take one more breath here. Good. Slowly bring your arms to the back as you come up with a straight spine. Take a little back bend. You can keep your knuckles laced or bring your hands to your lower back for some support. Good. Neutral spine. Let's do another Surya Namaskar. Bend the knees, arms lift, inhale, chair. Exhale, fold forward. Inhale, lengthen. Exhale, chaturanga. Inhale up. Exhale, back, down dog. Left heel turns down, right foot lunges forward. Arms lift, warrior one. Try to stay low through the legs. Exhale, lower the hands, step back, chaturanga. Inhale up. Exhale, back. Other side, right heel down. Left foot lunges, arms lift, warrior one. Exhale, chaturanga. Inhale up. Exhale, back. Take one more breath here as you exhale a little deeper through the hips. Then look forward and walk or jump, feet to the outside of your hands. Coming down to a yogi squat. So you all will stay facing the front of your mat. I'm just going to turn so you have a better angle. If you feel pressure in your knees or your hips, you can always sit on a block to kind of take the pressure out of those joints. Good. Now, see if you can hook your elbows to the insides of the knees and push your knees apart. As as you lengthen through your spine. You're trying to get as vertical as possible. You can stay or right hand down, anchor that hand down, and lift the left arm up. Good. Stay with the exalted arms or option to bind if you want to. Keep pulling your knees back, chest lifts. And try to squeeze your shoulder blades together as you keep pulling your knees back. One more breath here. Good, back to center. Lift, lengthen. And other side. Reach long, lengthen through the arms. Bind or stay. Keep pulling your knees back, chest lifts. One more here. Back to center. Lift and lengthen. So from here, you can lower your hands and shoot right back to chaturanga, or you can play with an arm balance. So if you're arm balancing, try to get to your pull. And by the way, if you don't have a curl pose at home on your own yet, put a pillow or a blanket in front. It's just like a mental thing. It'll help you start to lean forward more so that you'll eventually float your feet. A lot of times, it's just fear holding us back. So try to get your knees into your armpits or your elbows, and then keep leaning forward as you float your feet. Then once you feel more confident with it, you might start to lift your feet higher, heels together, toes apart. Take one more breath here. And then don't overthink it. Just shoot your legs back and land in chaturanga. Inhale up. And exhale back, down dog. Spread your toes. Keep pulling the hips up and back. And step your feet together. Right leg lifts. Open up the head. Start to bend your right knee. Kick it over to the left and sink your left heel down. Let that feel good as you open up your psoas, your hip. And then bring your knee into the nose. Shoulder shift forward, hover, and lunge the right foot. Back heel down, arms lift up to warrior one. Good, try to square off your own hips, point your right hip back and left hip forward, and ground the outer blade of that back foot. You might want a prop available. Good, now keep pulling your right hip back and start to lengthen, reach forward. Try to keep your front knee over your ankle, reach it longer, and then left hand down, right arm up, upward twist. Keep pulling the outer right hip back and reach your right arm up. Rotate the top palm and reach over your right ear. Try to stay low through the legs. One more here. Good, inhale, cartwheel the arms around and up, coming into warrior two. Now, in warrior two, I like to flip the palms up to help roll my shoulders down. Just give me a little more movement in my chest. Make sure your back foot's parallel to the back of the mat. Get a little deeper through the front leg, and then reach forward and exalt the warrior. Stay light off that back arm, maybe bind it. Back to warrior two. Right elbow to the quad. Left arm up. Rotate the top palm and reach the left arm over your head. Now you can stay right there or bring your hand down to a prop or all the way to the floor or option to bind. Bind usually makes you drop your chest, so make sure your chest is spinning up. If you can't spin your chest up, you just might not be ready for the bind today. That's okay. Then also, if it's easy to hold your hands, you'll eventually make the wrap of the grabber. So your right hand grabs your left wrist. Take one more breath here. Good, release that and inhale back up to standing. Straighten out the right leg. Heel toe the back foot closer. Flip the right palm, reach forward, and exalt your triangle. Keep lifting up out of your right side body. Again, staying light off your back hands. Shoulders down, kneecaps are lifted. Inhale, lift you up to stand. Look down, about a foot in front of the right big toe. Bend the knee and float to Ardha Shavasana. Remember, you've got props, you can use them. So you stay light off, or you stay light in the pose. Even if you are using the props or the floor, you don't want to dump into that. So try to lift away from the props, and maybe you eventually won't need them at all. Feel free to go over the moon if you want to challenge yourself a little. Take one more breath here. And then slowly back out, returning to triangle. Right hand down, left arm up. Gaze up at your left thumb. Relax your jaw, relax your shoulders. Inhale, lifts you up to stand. Place your hands behind your back. Again, you can use a towel or a strap. Pivot to face forward. Try to square your hips towards the front. Bend the right knee and float into a Warrior Three variation. Point the left toes, get longer through your lifted leg, and pull your chest forward. One more breath. And slowly lower, left foot to right, release the grip, and pause. Take a moment to close your eyes. Slow down your breathing, being so grateful that you're able to move. Inhale, arms lift, up and up. And exhale, fold forward. Inhale, lengthen, look up. Exhale, walk or jump, chaturanga. Inhale, upward facing. Exhale, back to downward facing. And then the other side. So step your feet together, left leg lifts. Open up the hip. Bend your left knee, flex the foot. Kind of sink your right heel towards the mat. Maybe it can touch by now. And knee to nose. Shift the shoulders forward, hover. And lunge the left foot. Back heel down, arms lift up to a warrior one. Good. Try to square off your hips towards the front. Again, you can always use your own hands to kind of move your hips. Sometimes that helps me. And also widening your stance, bringing your feet a little further apart can help too. Good, bring your arms up, nice long arms, shoulders drop down, and start to extend forward. Keep grounding through your back heel, bending your left knee, get deeper through the hips. Remember, you can use a prop. Right hand down, left arm up. Keep pulling the left hip back, rotate the top palm, and reach over the left ear. Bend your left knee, get deeper. And then try not to push off the floor. Instead, float yourself up, cartwheel up to a warrior two. Good, turn your back toes out. Get a little longer through your arms. And then just make that adjustment as you flip your palms up. See how that helps open your chest more. Reach forward and exalt into warrior, or exalted warrior. Good, you can stay light off the stand or maybe mind it. Back to warrior two. Left elbow to the quad. Make sure you're not dumping into that left shoulder. Stay lifted. The way you get deeper isn't by dumping, it's by bending your front knee, getting lower through your legs. And then rotate your palm and reach over your head. And here you've got lots of options. You can stay, maybe go to the floor, the block, or the full bind. Keep spinning your chest up and try to scoop your left hip under you more. Final breath here. Good. Release that. Return back to warrior two. Straighten up the left leg. Heel toe the back foot in closer. Flip the left palm. Reach forward and exhale. Kneecaps are lifted, gaze can be up or down. Inhale lifts you up. Look down, bend the left knee, and flip to a half moon. Flex the floating foot. Again, you can use your props to start to lift up away from the props so you're left less dependent on them, and then maybe you don't need them at all. Try to stack your body more sideways. An option to go over the moon if you did that last time. back into triangle. Legs are straight, left hand down, right arm up, and gaze up into right thumb. Again, you're trying to pull your right hip back so you feel that release through the psoas. One more breath. Grab the back heel, inhale, lift you up to stand. Place the hands behind your back, open up the chest, wrap your lower ribs in, so you're opening your shoulders, but you're not going for a full throttle back bend, right? You want to wrap your ribs in. Good. Now pivot to face forward, bend the left knee, and start to float your right leg, coming into a warrior three variation. Spread the toes, point your toes, and pull your arms back as you keep your chest lifted. One more breath here. And lower. Right foot to left. Release the bind. Close the eyes and pause. Inhale, arms lift out and up. Exhale, fold forward. Ooh, I feel the sweat dripping down my back, you guys. We have hot yoga all the time, right? We live in South Florida, naked. Inhale, lengthen. Exhale, down the palms, walk or jump back, chaturanga. Inhale, upward facing. Exhale, back to downward facing dog. Take one more here. Try to roll your sitting bones up as you lengthen the backs of your legs. Then step your feet together and lift to the right leg. Hips stay level. Sink the left heel. Knee to nose, shift your shoulders forward, hover, and lunge the right foot. Arms left out and up for crescent lunge. Get deeper through your front leg, bring the arms out, and then left elbow under your right for eagle arms. Elbows lift, shoulders down, hands away from your face. Then slowly start to bow forward as you float your left leg for a bound standing split. Then slowly come back up to stand. Bring your left knee with you, maybe it doesn't touch on the way. Lift the knee and step the left knee over the right. Keep bending your standing leg. If you can, double up your toes so you've got that double bind and sit a little deeper. And there's always an option to fold forward. Take one more here. And gently stand tall, unwrap only your legs, and swing the left leg back slowly. Then lunge back, left knee down, reach back, look back. Release the arms all the way out and up. You might want to walk available. Left hand comes right next to your hip, over to the left, and reach up and over through the right. And then lift yourself up and over to the right. You can go to the floor, but just make sure you don't fall with your hand forward, because then it drops my chest, or back, because then it's too much of the back leg. You want to be right next to your hip. That's why sometimes the block can be helpful. And then reach your left arm, open over. Good, back up to the center. Squeeze into your hips for stability. Bring the hands to prayer and twist to the right. So you're gonna hook your left elbow. Try to get your armpit over there if you can. That might be enough to stay right there, or you can lift your knee. Maybe exalt your arms. Maybe bend your arms. If you want the full pose, the Ashtanga variation, you can turn your back heel down, like in a warrior one. Keep spinning your chest up. Take one more breath. Good, unwind your hands. Straighten out the right leg and fold. Parsvottanasana. You might want blocks under your hands if you're not easily touching the floor today. Inhale, halfway lift. So interesting, right? We could do the same class every day, even though we don't. We could, but we could feel a completely different experience every time. Also depends on the time of the day, your stress level, your emotions, right? It all plays a part. So don't make anything like attachments. Don't expect a certain way to feel or anything like that. Just be in the moment every time you roll out your mat. Thinking of it as it's your first time you're practicing. Try to pull your outer right hip back. Inhale, halfway lift, lengthen, and exhale, fold deeper. Good, inhale, lengthen. Now try to ground your palms. Keep your legs as straight as you're able. Lift your back heel, lift up through the hips, and drag your right leg back. Open up the hip, you can bend your right knee, option to flip your dog if you want. Lower your right foot as you reach your right arm up, reach back, lift back. Maybe reach your arm out. And then flip back around. Lift your right leg, open it up again. And bring your right knee forward to pigeon. Walk the hands in, open up your chest. Gently walk it forward. Now, let's just stay in regular pigeon for now. I'm going to show you some options to play with in a bit. But for now, just be in the moment and rest. Let's check out what's going on in your hips. So you could stay in your regular pigeon, or if you want, grab one of those props that you have and actually place it in the front of your left hip. So like right in front of your left hip flexor. Then you can spread your left arm and bring the back of your left shoulder onto the floor. That might be enough. Or you can go for the full bind, reaching your right arm up and then bind it around, grabbing your right foot. Maybe your ankle, your heel, your right big toe. So with the bind, I mean with the block there, it helps so that you don't topple over to the left. It'll help you keep that good alignment so that you're getting primarily that right hip glute, right? That's where I feel it. And maybe obviously as you're twisting, you might feel it in your chest and your spine too. Try to relax your shoulders, your neck. Take a final breath here. And gently release that. Start to walk your hands in. Now, you can move that prop. Lean over to the right. Try not to use momentum or your hands. So you're going to use your core to lean to the right and swing your left leg around. Bring the left foot to the outside of the right knee. Left arm behind your back, right arm up. Hook up on the knee and twist. Inhale, lengthen. Exhale, twist. One more, inhale. Exhale. And just move your chin to the opposite shoulder. Counter over to the right side. And kind of bow onto the floor. Inhale up. And swing your right leg forward and bring the left foot to the outside of the left hip. You can peel your left calf out of the way. Now, if you feel pressure in your left knee, don't hesitate to sit on props because you shouldn't be feeling it in your knee. We want you to feel it in your left quadricep. You can also start to go back, if that feels okay, again on your knee, so that you feel a better stretch. And maybe you lie all the way on a block. Block can be nice if you're not ready But so if you're feeling really open, you can come all the way down. Then you could bend your right knee and kind of lean your knee over to the left. Maybe you grab opposite elbow above your head or cactus your arms, just bring them out to a T, anything that feels good in your upper body. And just enjoy a few deep, long breaths here. I could fall asleep here. But that wasn't always the case. And it's not always every day. Most of you are probably anxious to get out of bed. So if that is the case, see if you can stay in it for just two more breaths. Look for some kind of a release, some kind of a feeling of comfort, even in the discomfort. Start to kind of crawl your way out. You can swing your left leg forward and just shake your legs, let everything flop and jiggle. Good. Bend your knees, cross the ankles, vinyasa. And step the feet together, left leg lifts, hips stay low. Sink your right heel, knee into the nose, shoulders forward, hover, and lunge to the left foot. Arms lift, down and up. Bring your arms up and bring your right elbow under the left. Eagle arms. Start to bow forward and then float your right leg. Slowly come back up to a stand. Don't let your foot touch if possible. Bring the knee forward and stack right knee over the left. Squeeze the inner thighs together. Try to lift your elbows, hands away from the face. And again, option to fold forward. Keep pulling your right hip back so your knees stay in the midline as much as you can. One more breath. Inhale up, unwrap only the legs and swing the right leg back. Flex the foot, bend the left knee and lunge back. Drop your back knee, reach back, look back. Inhale up, unwrap the arms and lower left hand to the left. Again, you can use the props. And then lift up and over to the right. Opening up the whole left side body. Back to center, hands to a prayer. Squeeze into your hips and hook right elbow to the left. Try to get your thumbs at heart center. You can always stay or exhale or bind your arms. One more here. I felt that it was slow motion. I didn't fall, damn it, in the first video. I think I'm tired. Whatever. Embrace it, right? Falls are good. Even us teachers fall. And we should. I don't know where we were. That's okay. A few breaths, and then what do we do? Parsvottanasana, that's it. So lift your back knee and fold. Inhale, lengthen. Exhale, fold. Pull your outer left hip back. Ground your left big toe. Relax your neck. Keep grounding your back heel. Take one more inhale, halfway lift, lengthen. And exhale, fold. Inhale, lengthen. Now try to keep your palms down. Try to keep your legs as straight as you can. Lift the back heel and drag the left leg reach forward, look forward. Maybe reach out. Flip back around. Left leg lifts open. And bring your left knee forward to a pigeon. We're going to get the variation, but for now, just enjoy traditional pigeon. Your hands can come down. You can find something as a pillow if your head doesn't come all the way down comfortably yet. Okay, so you can stay in traditional pigeon. It might feel good just to be in that. Or if you want the twist, and you don't have to use a prop, but I like it because then I don't fall over to the left and I can focus more on my twist. So if you're going for the prop like we did last time, then you can place it right in front of your right hip crease, your hip flexor, that is. And then put your right arm underneath your chest so the back of your shoulder comes to the mat. And wrap your left arm around, maybe grabbing the outer edge of the foot, big toe, whatever's available, and roll the left shoulder back. Try to relax around your neck and your shoulders. One more breath here. Gently start to come on out of it. You can swing your right leg forward and shake out your legs. Cross the ankles, we'll move through a final vinyasa. From your down dog, maybe walk your hands back a little further. Look towards the front of the mat, bend your knees, high up onto the toes, and walk or float. That was a little smoother today. Okay. Lori's laughing at me in case you guys are wondering. Feel the flesh from the sitting bones, hands on the floor, toes back, shoulders back. Inhale, arms lift, and exhale, fold. Good. If you're easily touching your feet, you can always add a prop. Holding in. Try to get your belly to your quads. Take one more here. Inhale up. And bring your right foot to your left inner thigh. Feel the flesh from the left hip, arms lift up. Keep flexing your left foot, try to rotate your torso so your left ribs are pulling back, right ribs pull forward, and fold over the right leg. One more here. And slowly roll yourself up to seated. Draw the knees together, scoot your hips forward. And slowly bring your arms forward and roll yourself down, one vertebra at a time. Good, you can place your elbows next to your ribcage and walk the finger, or to walk your feet in. So as a measurement, you want to be able to touch your heels. And then inhale, lift the hips up. You can lace your hands behind you, kind of gives you more leverage to maybe walk your elbows under, chin away from chest, hips lift, and breathe. Slowly roll your spine down. You can do another second set, or hands come under your shoulders and press up to full wheel. Squeeze the elbows in on the way up, and inhale, lift you up. Keep lifting the hips, trying to work your arms, your legs straighter. And slowly lower upper back, mid back, lower back down. Keep your lower back pressing into the floor. Keep your feet on the mat. We've got one more to go. Final one, set up, and inhale, lift. Stay in it for two more breaths. Feel free to rock side to side. It always feels good, like
massaging your lower back.
Then you can stay or lay straight up, hands on the floor next to the hips, push into the hands, and lift your feet up over the head for a hop. Maybe lace your hands behind you. Now I usually keep my arms like that and go right into shoulder stand, but most people want the support with the hands on the lower back, so you can try either. And this, if you want, spread your toes, maybe come into a straddle split or bring one leg down at a time. Just kind of play around with anything that might feel good today. We usually stay in it 10 or 12 breaths, so there's no rush as we enjoy being upside down. If you're in the zone and you feel like you've gotten to that place of stillness, by all means, stay 5-10 more minutes, even longer. Placing the hands into Anjali Mudra. As we bow into you, acknowledging the self-discipline that this practice requires. May you thank your body for being able to move the way you did today. May we be grateful for the fact that we have access, we have resources to be able to connect online. Yogis, thank you for coming and practicing with us today. My hope is that this helps you find peace in a weird time. And my hope is that before we even realize it, we will be back in a beautiful space that we know and love at the Yoga Factory. So thank you so much, Yogis. Stay calm out there.